Good morning, students. So today we discussed about polynomials. Okay. So all of you know about the polynomials. Okay, so today we represent polynomials using single linked list. So only few people have joined, so I'm waiting for other people to join. So what is a polynomial? So what is the polynomial? So polynomial is an expression of more than two algebraic terms. Okay, especially the sum of several terms that contain different powers of the same variable, we call it as a polynomial. So in mathematical, polynomial is an expression consisting of variables and coefficients that involves only the operations of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and non-negative integer exponentation of variables. Okay, so generally we represent the polynomials in this way: a of x equal to a into suppose a m minus 1 and a x of e power n minus 1 and so on, a 0 and x power e 0. So this is the general we represent here, where a are the non-linear coefficients and a are the non-negative integer exponents. You already know the e naught, e 1, all the are the exponents, and a is the constant here. Okay. Clear, students? So see here, this is our polynomial. So why we are considering the polynomial means, so here applications of polynomials are evaluation of polynomials or adding of polynomials and multilinked data structures, that is sparse matrix, we will discuss in next class. And another application is arithmetic operations on long positive numbers. Okay, and we use this linked list in symbol table construction also. So these are the applications of linked list. One is evaluation of polynomials. Another one is addition of polynomials. Next one is multi-linked data structures, that is sparse matrices. Then we have to perform arithmetic operations on long positive numbers. And last one, we use this linked list in symbol table construction that comes under the compile reason subject. Okay. So how to represent the polynomial? For example, here we represent the Here COF means the coefficient, and EX means the exponent, and this is the nest link address. Okay. Okay, thus this is one way of representing polynomial. So we are just representing the linked list in stack in just way we represent in the same manner represent the here polynomial also in structure. Then see here how we represent means. Here we are considering here link, we are considering only one link is there that we are using for polynomial representation. Here only one link, so that is single link list we are using here. Okay, so in this first part consists the coefficient, second one is exponent, then third part is consider the link. Okay, so here here coefficient and exponents are stored in information, and link contains the next node address. So here how can using single linked list we can represent the polynomial here. So here there are three terms in the above polynomial. Okay, sorry, two terms in the above polynomial. So you have to represent here one is for coefficient and another one is exponential, and next one is link. So for see this example, 3 is coefficient, so 3 14, then next node address I construct here. My next node contains coefficient is 2, exponent a, and next is 1, and remaining last one is there is no x power, I return 0 and return null. Null means the polynomial expression is end here. Okay, in the same way we represented b 8 exponent 14 and minus 3 power 10 and 10 power 6, then after that no expression is there, then I return null value there. Okay, so this is representation of polynomials. So here we have to perform adding two polynomials. Now what are the rules for adding two polynomials? First we have to consider the first, if the exponents of the two terms are equal, first you have to consider the exponents. So if the exponents of the two terms are equal, then we add the two coefficients, and the new create new term for the adding the result, store the result there. And if the exponent of the is less than the that b, then create a duplicate term of b and attach this term to result. If you know, you know very well, if the exponents are same, then you add and store the result. If the exponents are not same, directly store the result in some result or temporary variable. Okay, so see here in this example, I'm considering these two. Say their exponents are same, so I add these two and store in some place. Okay, so here we considering the a of exponents equal to b of exponents. Yes, then add. Okay, so here in next case, these exponents are not equal, so just store the result in separately. We store the result here and we stores the result here. Okay, students, understand? And here the exponents are different, and same, we store the result in different way. Okay, so this is about adding of two polynomials. So for example, we have the equation is like this. See here. Okay. factor. So this is the expression here. Five x square y square z square plus 3 y square plus 4 x power cube z minus 1. So this is my polynomial expression. So here, how can I represent here? So here 5, 3, 4, minus 5 are coefficients in this expression. Okay. So we have to store coefficients in CF. Okay. Then we have x power is there, y power is there, z power is there. Then you have to consider to store the power of px in one variable, means there is power of x and the power of y and the power of z. These are three variables I am considering to store the power of x, y, z. And we have to consider another one is limit. Okay, clear. So one is for coefficient, one is for x power, one is for another y power, and another one is for z power. Okay. So how we represent this one? Just we already know that we can represent the linked list in struct. So struct node, and what we have to do, first we have to do the data type, then we have to do the link. So int cf px py pz. Okay, clear. Then what you have to do, use the self-reference structure, that is struct node star. Okay, then here just you have to write the as type define. Okay, type define the structure name. Struct node, already explained in previous class about linked list. When I am discussing about linked list, struct node, just we are using the node. So when we give the node means, it will directly take it as a pointer. For this purpose, we are writing like this. Okay, so in this way, how to represent. So how the blocks are allocated now? So here just you have to same, we are linking only one link field, but here total how many data types I'm taking? 4. So one is for 5 and one is for power of x, and that is the power of x is 2, another one is y, and another one is 2, and this one connect to the next block. Okay, so next block also contains what the next block contains. Here one coefficient is there, that is 3, and there is no x term 0, and there is a y term 2, and there is no z term 0. Then it connected to the another link. Okay, clear students? So in this way you have to represent the polynomial. Okay. Next, last one is 4, 3, and 0, and 1. Next, we have another coefficient, that is last one. All these are zeros, you can represent only minus 5. Remaining are all zeros. Last if you place null. Okay, in this way you have to represent the polynomials. Okay, clear students, are any doubt?
Okay, clear. Clear students? Ping me a message if you have any doubt.
See students here and additional polynomials using a single linked list, circular single linked list. So here additional polynomials using circular single linked list. So here I am giving only here two exponents here, there px, py. I am not considering third means third power. I am only two powers I am taking. Okay. Then see here students. So if you want to insert a node in the circular single linked list, so insert a parent here. Okay. So insert a parent means if there is any node is available in the list. Okay, so here we are using only one function, that is inserted rare and okay. So this is inserted rare and we are taking two variables, temp and current. So if temp equal to get node, so I am considering the new node, the coefficient I am giving, all these values are stored in temporary variable, and temp of flag equal to zero given there. Then the first node address is stored in head. So current of head of link, I am stored here. Here current of link not equal to head. The loop is incremented. Then the return this statement. You already know that this condition. See here, I am checking the condition in display. That is if head of link equal to head. If there is only one node, the head of link is the head means. The polynomial does not head, then if this condition falls, then temp equal to head of link. So temp equal to head of link means see here. So this is my node, okay, and head of link equal to head. So this node address is 101. Thus this node name is head. So head of link equal to head. So this is head of link. Head is 101. Head of link is 101. List is empty. Okay. If the list is not empty, then temp of head equal to temp equal to head of link. So if the list is not empty, we store the next node address. So that is temp equal to now what the value, what the address is there? Temp equal to 102. So while temp of not equal to head, you have to print the statements in the link. So in link, what are the elements are there? You have to print those elements. Okay. See here, I am considering the coefficient by x power, y power, and also coefficient I want to print there. Then I have to increment temp equal to temp of link. So here, why I am considering temp not equal to head means you want to print the only information, use this. Okay. Temp not equal to null. You want to print the information, use this. Okay. So then you have to perform addition operation of two polynomials. So I am considering H1, H2, and node H3. So see here, P1 means pointer 1, is H1 of link is connected to pointer 1, and H2 of link is connected to pointer 2. Okay. While P1 not equal to H1, just consider the P1 value, and while P2 not equal to H2, we consider the P2, then you have to check the coefficients. If both are same, break. If both are not equal, add the coefficients and return flag. If flag 0 means both are not equal, flag 1 means both are equal here. After that, you can insert at rear end. The solution is inserted at rear end. Okay, clear students? Any doubt? So what is H1 and what is H2 here? Sir, what is H1 and what is H2? So here H1 contains the address of the header node of the first polynomial, and H2 contains the address of the header node of the second polynomial. So header node is nothing but it contains the first node address. Okay. So H1 contains the first polynomial address and H2 contains the second polynomial address. So if you want to add two polynomials, first you have to search for power of polynomials 1 in power of polynomials 2. Okay, so you have to search for power of polynomials 1 in power of polynomials 2. So what we have to do is, so see here, now share while P2 not equal to H2. P2 not equal to H2 means here coefficient of X and coefficient comma power of X, power of Y. Okay. This is power of X and this is here. This is power of X and this is power of Y and this is power coefficient. Okay. Then you have to check the condition. If condition false, break. Otherwise, you obtain the next term of the polynomial 2. 2 here. Okay, append the polynomial 2 here. And these conditions here, while P naught not equal to H1, as long as the term of polynomial 1 exists, as long as the term of polynomial 1 exists, then we have to x1 is power of this, x1 is the power of x, y1 is power of y, tf is coefficient. Okay, then we have to search, then you have to search the power, that is p2 not equal to h2, this condition. If p2 not equal to h2 means add two coefficients. Okay, if the p2 not equal to h2 means add two polynomials, that is p2 not equal to h2 means the power, add coefficients, that is power of polynomial found in power of polynomial 1. So p2, if p2 not equal to h2 means power of poly 1 found in poly 2, both are same. So then you have to add the coefficient, then you have to store the result in H3. So if the coefficients are not equal, then you just if the powers are not equal, different, then directly add to the H3. Okay, so in this way you have to write the program for polynomials using circular single linked list. Okay, clear students? Just I run this program. One minute. See here, why I write the -9 9 minus 9 9 9 makes when the coefficient and we represented with -9 9. Okay. Okay, students, clear students, or any doubt? Here enter the first polynomial. What is the coefficient I want to enter here? Five. Insert five. Then what is the power of x is 3 and power of y is 2. Then enter the second term. Okay, second term is 4 and power of x is 2 and power of y is 1, and enter the third term. Okay, third term I inserted as 6. Okay, then I give the power is 0 and power of y is 0. Then if you want to end the expression, you just print right triple. Here, what the message is come here? Enter the second polynomial. Okay. When you write minus triple means the polynomial is n here. Okay, so next write the second polynomial. I'm writing coefficient 10 and power 3 and power 2, and next one is coefficient 4, next one is 11 and power 1 and power 1, and last one is 12. Okay, then power is 0 and power is 0. Then I write the expression here, minus 999. That means that the terminal, see here, first polynomial 5x cube y square, 5x cube y square, and here 4x square y power 1. See here, these two coefficients are same, so 15 is there, remaining all different, so I can add only these constants here. Okay. Okay, students, clear or any doubt? So just see the program here. See here, if coefficient equal to coefficient minus 999, then break. You just write there only minus 999 only. If you write anything, it will not consider. If you write only minus 999, you just and the polynomial expression 1. Okay students, and we have double linked list program is also there. I forgot to write the double linked list, forgot to run the double linked list program. You already run the single linked list program. So see here, students, double linked list, we have different operations are there: insertion at front end, insertion there end, delete front end, delete there end, display. Okay, so I want to insert at front end. I'm giving choice 1. Then I give the element 10. Next, enter your choice. I want to insert another element front end. Then I want to insert 20. Okay. So just we see the display. What are the elements is display here? So first I inserted 10, then 20 from front end. So display is correct. Then I want to insert at rear end. So insert rear, and I think we after 10 we have to come there 30. Insert rear end 40. Then display. See here, insert rear means you have to insert rear end. So 30, 40, insert front means first you insert 10, then 20. Okay, if you want to delete 10, 10, 20 will delete it. Delete rear 40 is deleted. So first you delete front. End. 20 is deleted. Okay. And a display function only 110, 30, 40. If you delete rear, 40 is deleted here. Okay. So in this way, you have to perform double linked list. See the program here. I am repeating the program. So I already told you struct node. This is self-reference structure. We represent as node. You don't write every time star node. Just if you represent in this way, just directly node represent means it is a pointer. So get node is a pointer. So it's consider. So here double linked list contains two links. One is left link and another one is right link. Okay. So how we get the node means malloc size struct node. Okay, we already know flex equal to null. List is empty or memory is not available. Return X. What is the use of free node? Free node is used to delete the node or delete the existing node in the list. Okay, students. So far clear or any doubt? Okay, so if you are inserted front end, if there is a linked list, is the double linked list, inserted front end, if you want to insert or insert front end, then first you have to get a node from the available list. So that is, I'm considering two nodes, one is temp and another one is current. Okay, temp equal to get node. I am getting the new node from the available list. And then temp of info equal to item. I want to store item. And see here, if you want to insert at front end. So if you want to insert at front end. So this is the double linked list. So if you want to insert at front end, you want to insert here. So if you insert means, what is this node contains? This node contains what value? This node contains the null. Double English, it contains the null. And right link contains the next node address. Okay. So here we are taking some temporary variable current. So current equal to head of right link. So current equal to head of right link, I store this node address. Okay. So head of right link equal to temp. So head of right link equal to temp. So what does it mean that, see here, here one concept is there. We have one concept is there, that is head. So what is head means? What is head means? Here in previous notes, in previous I am discussing about head contains the address of the first node. Okay, head contains the address of the first node. But here we have one header node is there. In previous time, talk only head. Here, header node is there. So header node means, header node contains, header node is the first node of the single linked list or double linked list. So this is header node for double linked list. This is header node for single linked list. Okay. So header node is the first node of the linked list. Just like we have in train, we have first node is engine. So first one is in the same way we are using for linked list here, header node. Header node contains the, header node is the starting node of the linked list. So what is the header node of info contains and header node of link contains? So header node of info contains total number of nodes connected in the list. So here this is header node. How many nodes are connected? Only one node. So how many nodes are connected here? Only one node. So here in this info, what you have to write is one. Okay, if the head of link contains the head, head node contains the head address means list is empty. Okay, so that's why I have to store the head of right link equal to temp. So head of right link means head is the starting node. If you want to insert any node, head is first node for the linked list. So you have to insert here. This is fixed for every linked list. Header node is the starting node of the linked list. In single linked list, It contains the how many links are there? Only one node is there. If there are two nodes, then the info field contains two nodes. So what is header node means? Header node is the starting node of the list. Header node is the starting node of the list. If you want to insert a node at front end, after header node only you can insert. Okay, if you want to insert at front end after header node, because header node is the first node, you cannot delete or cannot replace that. To get inserted at front, so you cannot remove train engine and you can run the train. No, in the same way, you cannot remove the header node. If you want to insert at front node, you just insert at then you can insert after the header node only. Okay, clear? Clear, students? Any doubt? So just a header node is a linked list. Link feed always using header node, any node in the list can be accessed. Okay, using header node, any node in the list can be accessed. So the info field of the header node usually does not contain any information, and such a node does not represent in the list. So for that, we are using that info field as number of nodes in the list can be stored in the info field. So if the list is empty, the link field of header node contains null. So in single link list, here this is my head. Okay, so here null means if the head is null means the list is empty. Okay, if the head of info contains 5 means the node contains 5, the linked list contains 5 nodes. Okay. Okay, students. So that is about header node. And in double linked list, the left link and right link contains the null in the header node, and then the list is empty. Okay, so that is about header node, and I discussed the addition of polynomials, and tomorrow we discuss about sparse matrix. That is end of our third unit. Okay, so for any queries, please write a message in chat box. Thank you, students.